Hello everyone, welcome back to this channel My Research Support. Today we'll discuss 8 best journals for quick publication. Friends, I have mentioned quick publication, that does mean for sure you have to compromise in the quality. There are certain excellent journals, but their publication duration is around 1 year, 1.5 year, 2 years, or even more than that. So I have also mentioned here best journal. This is because the journals we are going to discuss have been included in the quality databases, quality indexings like SCOPUS, Web of Science. So definitely these journals are good, and these journals also fulfill our purpose. Many students doing their research at master level, at PhD level, and they have to publish certain number of papers in these types of journals in prescribed time duration. So definitely quickly you will be able to publish in these types of journals. Friends, I am having a separate video and how to select the best journals. The link is there in the description, and by clicking on the above I button you can access it. So at the last we will discuss two examples. We will discuss that the journals, those were in the SCOPUS index list till last year, but those are not there in the current year. So you need to be aware of these types of journals while publishing your research article, because if you publish your research article in these types of journals, then it will not be considered as SCOPUS index or Web of Science or SCI index document. So you will lose your document. You won't be able to publish it in any other publication. Prior to start the video, I would like to let you know that what you will get here in this video. So friends, if you are searching for the journals, those will quickly publish your research articles, then yes, this video is for you. So we'll see the publication duration. So the journal that we have mentioned in this video having publication duration which may vary from 1 month to 6 months, we will discuss this, and then we'll turn toward quality of the journal. So quality is well explained, well decided by the indexing. So if the journal is SCOPUS indexed as well as Web of Science or SCI index journal, then definitely quality of that journal is good. Quality is also decided by the impact factor and SGI index, CIMAGO journal ranking index. So we'll discuss these parameters also. Then we'll turn towards formatting requirements. Few journals strictly follows formatting requirements, but few journals demands us to submit a simple document with simple formatting guidelines. Those you'll get there in the author guidelines section. Then important parameter, which is APC, article processing charges. So friends, almost all the journals I have mentioned in this video are unpaid journals. Only I have involved two journals, those are paid journals, but their article processing charges are very less, so we can easily afford this. And then we'll move towards acceptance rate. What is the probability if I am going to submit my research article to that particular journal, then what is the probability that it will accept? So we'll see the acceptance rate, and then we'll turn towards the last parameter, which is plagiarism. So journal wise plagiarism requirement also will vary. You should ensure to keep plagiarism as low as possible. So I will suggest you to keep plagiarism less than 5% or less than 10%. For that you can use Turnitin software. Turnitin software can be used to remove the plagiarism. So friends, if you are using someone's work, someone's sentences, someone's paragraphs in your research article, then it is fine, but it should be properly cited. It won't be considered as plagiarism. And the last parameter is theme of that journal. So I have selected journals. Those will publish research articles of all streams of science, technology, engineering and management. So if you need specific points, then you can visit that particular journal website. So you will get insights into it. The first journal that we are going to discuss is JusTech, Engineering Science and Technology and International Journal. We have already discussed this journal. So on the internet, you will find two JusTech journals. One is of Taylor and Francis publication, and this journal is of Elsevier publication. That journal is also SCOPUS index, but it is paid journal, and this journal is SCOPUS as well as Web of Science index journals. So friends, Web of Science is having basically two important editions. First is Science Citation Index expanded, and second is Emerging Sources Citation Index journals. So this is ESCI journal, means Emerging Sources Citation Index journals. So as it is SCOPUS index journal, it is having SJR, CIMAGO journal ranking, which is 0.765 for this journal, and as it is Web of Science index journal, it is having SNIP, Source Normalized Impact Factor, which is 2.432 for this journal, which is really very good. And as I said, this journal is free for publication. That means you need not to pay any publication charges, but this journal comes under open access category. We have discussed this category in my previous video. The open access category and subscription category. In open access category, authors needs to pay the publication charges. But here in this journal, there is a university, Karabug University, who has funded all the publication charges. So even though your documents will be openly accessed by anybody in the world, author need not to pay any amount. Publication duration for this journal is around 3 to 6 months. So this again depends on the authors, how the authors will respond to the comments. Whenever revisions will come, we have to respond as quickly as possible within 1, 2, or 3 days. Then definitely the revision time will be reduced and publication time will be reduced, so that you will be able to publish your research article in 3 to 6 months. So formatting requirements, we have to submit a manuscript in simple, by following simple formatting guidelines, means single column, 12 size font, simple line spacing, few captions of figures, tables, etc. And the final editing or final formatting will be taken care by the journal editorial team itself. So, and plagiarism for this journal, you have to keep plagiarism less than 10%. As I said, for that you can use Turnitin software. I have already published in this journal, so I would like to tell you one incident. If you are going to submit your research article in this journal, and if your research article is not up to the mark, then after few days you will get a sweet email from the editorial team that we cannot handle your manuscript due to large volume. So it is straightway the journal has rejected your manuscript, but by the other way. So you can think why you have got this email. The second journal where you can publish your research article is IJET, International Journal on Emerging Technologies. So friends, it is very easy to publish in this journal as compared to previous journal. This journal is newly added in the SCOPUS database. It is there in the SCOPUS since 2018. So SJR index, SIMAGO journal ranking index, is not yet generated. This journal is free. There is no any publication charges, article processing charges. If your manuscript is within 30 pages, if it exceeds 30 pages, then you might have to pay certain charges. Acceptance rate of this journal is very high. The possibility to get published is again very high. Formatting requirements, you will find a formatting template, word template on this journal website. So you can go to the journal website, you can download the template, you can place your manuscript according to that template, and you can send your manuscript. And publication duration, again, publication duration as compared to previous one, publication duration is very less. It requires 2 to 3 months to publish your research article. The next journal that you can consider for the publication is WJST, Valalik Journal of Science and Technology. This journal is from Thailand. So this is the old journal which is included in the SCOPUS database. So it is there in the SCOPUS since 2012. This is also free or unpaid journal. That means authors need not to pay any publication charges. So time duration, publication duration is also less as compared to previous case. You can quickly publish in this type of journal. So publication duration is around 2 months. Acceptance rate is little bit low. It is around 30 to 35%. And formatting requirements, you will find a standard template on the journal website. So you can follow the instructions and you can submit your manuscript. The next journal is PRJ Material Science. The quality of this journal is really good if you compare this with the first journal, JustTech. This journal is also SCOPUS indexed as well as SCI index journal. It is there in the SCOPUS database since 2013. Its SGR index is also very high. It is 1.037 and impact factor is 2.35, which is again really very good. So it is a little bit difficult to publish in this journal because it is open access journal. That means your articles will be openly accessed by anybody, but for that you need to pay the publication charges, and publication charges for these journals are $1,000, and from my point of view this is very high amount. So I will never recommend you to go with this amount, but there is a provision. If your country lies under the low income countries, then definitely this publication fees will be waived off for those researchers. So in that case also, it is really good to publish in this journal because quality of journal is really very good, and if publication fees is waived off, then definitely go for that. But I will never recommend you to go with this publication charges because this is really very high amount. But this journal is comes under quick publication category. This will publish your research article within 1 to 2 months only, but it strictly adheres to the formatting requirements. This journal may reject your article due to formatting requirements also. So you have to strictly follow the formatting guidelines and you have to submit the manuscript. The next journal that you can consider for publication is IJAST, International Journal of Advanced Science and Technology. This is again SCOPUS Index journal since 2016. SGR index of this journal is 0.13, and this journal comes under subscription category. It means authors need not to pay any amount, but if as a third person I need to download the manuscript, then I have to pay certain amount or I have to subscribe for that particular journal. So this journal have not mentioned about any publication charges, but what I feel is subscription category journals, authors need not to pay any publication charges. So this publication fee will be waived off, and pages will be, minimum number of pages will be 10 and maximum number of pages will be 18. So your manuscript should lie in between 10 to 18. But if it exceeds 18 pages, then you have to pay an extra amount. This journal also follows fast publication policies, fast revision policy. This will publish your research article within 2 to 3 months only. But you have to ensure that plagiarism of my research article is less than 5%. If it exceeds 5%, then definitely author and all the co-authors will be blacklisted for this particular journal. And you won't be able to publish your research article in this journal for 3 years. For formatting requirements, you will find standard template, you have to follow the guidelines and you have to submit your manuscript. Next journal that you can consider for publication is IJASEIT, International Journal on Advanced Science, Engineering and Information Technology. This is also SCOPUS Index journal and SGR index is little bit high, it is 0.23. This journal comes under open access category. That means there are certain publication charges that the authors need to pay. The publication charges are $255, but there is a provision, if your H index is 15 or more than that, then you will be waived off for these publication charges. Means if the authors have published 15 publications and they are having 15 citations each, then their H index will be 15. So if your H index is 15, then only you will be waived off for this publication charges. In that case only I will recommend you to go for this journal. Acceptance rate of this journal is very low, it is 17.85% only, but it again follows the fast publication policy. It will publish your research article within 2 to 3 months. You will get standard template on the journal website for the journal submission. The next important journal is IJSTR, International Journal of Scientific and Technology Research. This journal is also newly added in the SCOPUS database. This is SCOPUS Index journal, so it is there in the database since 2018. So HJR is not it created, as it is newly added. So this journal also comes under open access category. This journal is not free or unpaid journal, but the publication charges for these journals are only $65. So this is very less amount. So I can recommend, if you can afford this amount, you can go for publication in this journal, because as compared to the other journal, this journal will also quickly publish your research article, and this will take around 1 to 1.5 months to publish your research article. So formatting requirements are also not very tough. You can just download that standard template from their website and you can submit your manuscript. The next choice of journal is JARDCS, Journal of Advanced Research in Dynamical and Controls. This journal also almost controls all the streams from science, technology and engineering. So for specific insights, you can refer the journal website. This is also SCOPUS Index journal whose SGR index is 0.11, and acceptance rate of this journal is very high. It is around 58%. So possibility is very high to publish in this journal. This journal is also quickly publishes within 1 to 2 months time duration. Also this journal can publish your research article, but regarding publication charges, these journals have nothing mentioned on this website. So I have written an email to the editor also. So as soon as I will get the information, I will convey you. If anybody has the information about publication charges for this particular journal, then you are welcome. Please write me in comments so that everybody will get an idea about the publication charges. So friends, this publication duration that I have mentioned for all these journals is based on my analysis. I have visited the home pages of these journals and I have downloaded many research articles those are already published in these journals, and then I came to know that the publication duration will be from this to this. So this is not 100% applicable, but yes, it is true, it can be deviate from the duration that I have mentioned. So friends, one more important point, how will you know that whether the journal is in the current SCOPUS or SCI index list? For that, we will consider two examples. So friends, this was all about the journals for quick publication. In my next video, we'll discuss best unpaid journals from quality point of view. So thank you very much for watching this video. Please like this video. Do not forget to subscribe this channel to get more research updates. And see you in my next video. Bye-bye.